Hi.
Welcome back
to another segment of Patricia Stewart Originals. Today I'm going to be using both my 3x5 gel plate and my 8x10. And I will be using Golden So Flat acrylic paints. I'm going to start by applying some of this yellow green using my 2-inch sprayer, spreading it on there and the plate. And as you could see, the bubbles that collect between the larger plate and the smaller, we get some nice bubble effect. And that residue of this paint, I'm just going to put on a cleanup sheet. Then I will go in with cadmium orange . Now the So Flat goes on velvety smooth, so I like about it. I'm going to lay that color there. And again, my cleanup sheet. Okay, then we have a little teal. Has a tendency to get all over my hands as it's coming from a small jar. Then I will do, what do we have here? Oh, pink. I will run this pink at the top as well. Okay. And I have some I'll do a little cadmium red. Okay. those little cells due to the bubbles in between both of the plates. I like that effect. And let's do one more. This yellow. Don't want to cover up the green totally. Some other yellow plate. Go here. Okay, clean up sheet. Now I'm going to pull this, but I have to let the red and the yellow dry just a little bit more, and then I can come and pull it. In the meantime, while we're waiting for that to dry, this was my cleanup sheet. I'm just going to cut the white edges off. And I want to make some use of this. I'm going to use my circle puncher. Get some nice circles here. Circles that can be used. Bottom, you get these nice circles of color that can be used. Never know what they can be used for, but I'll have them. And I have a smaller puncher as well, but I mainly like working with the larger circles. Okay. So here are nice gel printed circles for when I'm ready to use them. So we want to always try to make use of even our cleanup sheets and things like that. Okay, so this should be dry. Let's pull this, and I think I'm going to use a little bit of the fluid acrylics to pull it. Maybe the Titan Green. Photo matte paper. My Baron, apply a little pressure. Let this sit for a bit on here before I pull it up. Now earlier I was working on some cards, my 500 index card challenge, using the same 3x5 gel plate. And so now that I've cut these circles out, these also can be great to apply as a design to whatever I'm working with. It can add something to the design. And so I think that's what I will use these for. And on the white, I will do some mark making with my pen, sort of darken the edge of the circles so that they would stand out. So I think that would work nicely. Giving something different, a different gel pull to these index cards. Okay, let's pull this up. See how much some of the paint has stayed on the plate. You can never judge how it's going to come out. But those are the layers. And these days I've been more interested in my ghost prints. Okay. So whatever was left on the plate that didn't come up left the white spots. That's a bit disappointing. But I will take a pull, the ghost print. Previous paper. That barely had a ghost print on it, and only to not be able to find it now. So I'll take a fresh piece. Don't know where it disappeared to. Question is, when print doesn't come out well for us, what is the next option for us to do? Okay, so here's what was left on the plate. So I can go back in and create something with that. And I'm thinking of using circles that I have, like those, and this here, using the flat paint. Come in and let's see what happens when we try to add to something that didn't quite come out the way that I wanted. Okay, and so we want to see some of the design come through. So I'm going to use a solid color on this, and I think I will go with, should I go in with a darker color, like black, or a lighter color? Okay, so I'm going to go in with this pale yellow. Let's see how well we can get this. Way too much. Okay. So whatever is not covered, yellow, will show up. Let's try it. Stuff here. Sometimes we can have a good day pulling prints And at other times, it's a bust. But we go with it regardless. Here we have circles, and so we will do another layer of circles. Okay, so I have other circles here. So let's go in with a darker color this time. And so I'll do a little Payne's gray. I won't use as much paint this time. And I'm going to go right over it. I will go in one more time with the circles. One more color. Okay, and I think I will go in with a little teal. That might save the day. I've used these circles so many times, so they're not hugging the plate as much, so it might be time to retire them. Or toss them. I think it's time to toss them. So although my print did not come out exactly the way I wanted it to, we can just have fun creating and playing. But I like this. So, that's a lesson in when things don't work out. What do? Do you toss the print, or you come up, sit, and figure out how can we utilize the color, the pattern, but now we may have to pull out a stencil. Simple stencil to go on top and to try to create something different than we started out with. And there are times when what I had in mind, what I envisioned, is not what happened, no matter how many times I tried it. Some days are that way with gel printing, but it's not a failure. It's an opportunity to start thinking outside the box. It's an opportunity to now move in a different direction, because there might be a greater creative approach that you stumble upon in the process of trying to make something of it. So I'm satisfied with this. I could use Posca pens to do some tracing around a few of the circles, or leave it just like this. So I still get all the colors I started with, but a different design. So it paid to stick with it and work it out. So thanks for joining me today, and keep doing art, keep thinking outside the box. Till next time.